Kasese is a hilly, has a lot of hills, in the mountains, and most communities live in the mountains. If you look at the topography of Kasese, there's a lot of gullies and rivers flowing, which means you need a lot of crossing. I think Kasese is one of the districts which is endowed with rivers. So once you have rivers crossing in many places in the district, of course, you need to cross over.
Yeah, the purpose of building a bridge is that we wanted to improve on the road network, so that we can improve the life of the people. Because in this area, it was only this bridge, and it was overflooded, so we decided to help them and build this bridge.
In the process of building an arch bridge is quite simple, but basically we start with the preliminary survey, where we go and look at the site and look at the flow of water. We estimate the quantity of water which will be going through the bridge, and even get some information from the communities to see where normally the floods are. We also have a meeting with the local communities where they form up a road committee, because they have a role to play by collecting the available materials like stones, sand, if at all they could get them in their vicinity. Because we normally ask them to contribute, and the contribution they make is basically for sense of ownership. Because once a community participates in this activity, they feel that the project is their own. Even if we left yesterday or tomorrow, they will feel that's part of them and they can really protect it.
The community, these are the people normally that are bringing us stones from different villages around. With BTC, they carry supervision, providing masons, paying some laborers, buying sand, then cement, and assisting in mobilizing and people about providing local materials. And I'm a mason here under BTC. For us, the big work is to put. We have labor constructing the bridge. We are the people are trying to show them the types of stones we need. Like especially when we reach to carve the arch, we normally select some stones, and we are the people are showing them the right things.
Mzamsan, I'm a wawai.
If you look at the enormous need of bridges in Kasese, and you put in the cost implication, if you had to construct like in the concrete bridges, the money would be too much, and the funds for sure are not there. But when we looked at the availability of materials, and looked at the possibility of involving the community, for sure this technology was more appropriate compared to other technologies. Just have your stones, your cement, and then a framework which don't need quite high skilled laborers or someone with a bachelor's or master's to construct. The moment you get the method of doing it and of putting it up, for sure it's not difficult, because you look at the masons we trained for almost 2 days. But now they have managed to grasp the technology and they can reconstruct. But the technology is quite cost effective. For a stone arch bridge, can cost around 20 Uganda million shillings. And then if you compare with a concrete bridge, it will go to close to 150 Uganda million shillings.